Amen. Well, we're thankful to have you here with us tonight. I know there's a lot of people in here, and it's crammed in tight, and it may get a little hot or a little uncomfortable. Maybe they can cut some, well, they've got some fans going tonight. But we're glad that you come out to be with us. Got a great play this year called A Change of Heart. The main star of the play here, she's in need of a heart transplant, but the real theme of the story is she's got a greater spiritual need. She needs a change of heart. And there's a great cast of people that's worked hard on this play, and they practice a lot, so we want you to give them your attention tonight. Pay attention, laugh, enjoy it, have a good time. And we love you and appreciate you coming. So I think the little children's going to do a play first, ain't they? Amen. God bless you. We'll have word prayer. We'll start the word prayer. We'll do that. Father, we bow our heads tonight, and God, we just thank you for this opportunity to be in your house. Lord, we thank you for each one that's come. We thank you for these that's worked so hard on this program this year. And Lord, I pray, God, that you would bless everyone that's involved, Lord. I pray, God, that you would bless the program tonight. Lord, that your spirit, God, would speak to us. Father, I pray, God, that we would see what you'd have us to see. Lord, if there's somebody here, God, just like the story of the play that needs a change of heart, God, we pray tonight, Lord, that you, Lord, will perform that change of heart upon them as only you can. Bless these children now as they do their part. God, we thank you, Lord, and ask you these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Wise men on their way. beautiful star of hope.
Christmas is the celebration of the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. As we see Christmas decorations all around us this season, if we look at them in the right way, we can stay focused on the true reason for the season, Jesus Christ. We now present to you some symbols of Christmas and what they mean to us.
Angels symbolize the importance of the angels who appeared over Bethlehem to announce Jesus' birth. Angels are perfect symbols for faith, devotion, hope, trust, and love.
Christmas candles remind us that Jesus Christ is the light of the world. They can also remind us to be lights to others, and to help others come to know Christ.
A green thriving tree in the dead of winter reminds me of hope and a new life. Because of Jesus Christ, we can have everlasting life. So we can choose to see the evergreen tree as a natural symbol of Him and His gift to us.
The circular shape of the Christmas tree represents eternity and God's never-ending love towards us.
The poinsettia is a plant that thrives during the winter and symbolizes new life. Their shape also resembles a star, like the one that led the wise men to Jesus. Red poinsettias reminds us of the blood of Jesus Christ shed for us.
The sharp edges of the holly leaf can remind us of the crown of thorns placed on Jesus' head. The red holly berries remind us of his blood shed for all of us.
Snowflakes are sent from above, all very unique, no two alike. Just as we are fearfully and wonderfully made, so is each snowflake. They cover the world in whiteness, just as Jesus covers our sin and gives us grace and mercy.
Christmas bells symbolizes the announcement of the birth of Christ when angels in heaven praise God and declare glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men.
The color green is a symbol of everlasting life, while red represents the blood of Jesus when he died for our sins on the cross. Romans 6:23 says, "For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord."
A fruit basket represents the fruits of the Spirit: love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, and temperance.
Just as the angels proclaim Christ's birth to the shepherds, Christmas cards represent the word of Christmas being shared to all the world.
Christmas is the season of giving. The wise men came to Jesus and presented them unto him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. But the greatest gift of all came from our Heavenly Father. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. As you open your brightly wrapped present on Christmas morning, remember that Jesus Christ is our Lord and Savior, is the true gift of Christmas.
The star represents the star that appeared in the sky when Jesus Christ was born.
Amen.
Jesus Christ died on the cross, shedding his blood, the only acceptable payment for our sins, just like John 3:16 says.
That there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. To be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
stable long ago. Laid him in a manger there, wrapped in swaddling clothes. Angels told the shepherds of the babe in Bethlehem. Hastily they made their way to see the newborn lamb. Mary's little lamb, son of the great I am. There in that small town, the Lord of heaven above came down. This perfect little lamb, no spot or blemish on him was found. The greatest gift of God's love did abound. Mary's little lamb.
A star shone bright, a guiding light to help the wise men on. Marvelous birth, Christ came down to earth to complete salvation's plan. Born to be the sacrifice for all the sins of man.
Mary's little lamb, son of the great. Small town, the Lord of heaven above came down. This perfect little lamb, no spot or blemish on him was found. The greatest gift of God's love did abound. Mary's little lamb, the greatest gift of God's love did abound. Mary's little lamb,
the greatest gift of God's love did abound.
Mary's little lamb.
Keep in watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them,
Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people, for unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you: ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying,
Glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men.
And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another,
Still doing that. smile toward evil unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which is turned to pass, which is the one hand and known unto us.
And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they had made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told unto them. Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet. And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah. For out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel. Then Herod, when he had privately called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search diligently for the young child, and when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. And when they were departed, behold, the angel of the Lord appeareth to Joseph in a dream, saying, Arise and take the young child and his mother and flee into Egypt. And be thou there until I bring thee word, for Herod will seek the young child to destroy him. When he arose, he took the young child and his mother by night and departed into Egypt.
Hallelujah. shepherds left their flocks by night to see this baby wrapped in light. A host of angels led them all to you. It was just as the angel said, you'll find him in a manger bed. Emmanuel and Savior, hallelujah. 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 A star shone bright up in the east to Bethlehem. The wise men three came many miles and journeyed long for you. Into the place at which you were, their frankincense and golden myrrh they gave to you and cried out. This baby boy would grow to be a man and one day die for me and you. My sins would drive the nails in you. That rugged cross was my cross too. Still every breath you drew was hallelujah.
Mother would have been so proud.
Thank you. I wish we could go see her. I really miss her.
We'll try to drive up there on Saturday, but right now let's get you home.
Okay.
Nurse! 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 Nurse!
I'm sorry. How can I help you?
Well, there's nothing wrong with me. I just thought I'd lay here and scream till I passed out.
I'm sorry.
Who are you?
I'm Harley.
Do you work here?
No. Yeah. Yes. No.
Excuse me?
What I mean to say is, I do work here, but not for another 12 minutes. They told us in nursing school that humor was the best way to make patients feel better.
You, at nursing school, huh? So this ain't your first day of work here at this hospital? This is your first day of work in any hospital?
Yes. Yes, it is, but I graduated in the top 10% of my class, and I have many field experiences, and I come both dedicated and prepared to give you the best possible care.
Who are you trying to convince, me or you?
Both.
Well, Harley, when you do go to work in 12 minutes, do you think that you might could get somebody to come and look at this thing and see if they could get it to work?
Here, let me look at it. A lot of times it just loses connection, and you just have to tap it. Hello? Hello?
I beg your pardon!
Nurse Lisa, hello.
I'm well Lily. Aware of who you are. What I want to know is what you're doing in this patient's room.
Well, you see, I
thought I made it perfectly clear to you that you were not to provide any patient care until you completed your orientation.
Yes, ma'am.
And furthermore, we do not strike hospital equipment. Is that clear?
Of course not.
Now, Latresa, your doctor has ordered another echocardiogram and a stress test. An orderly will be down in us shortly to take you to the lab.
Do you think I might could get Tylenol, aspirin, something for my headache?
There is nothing in the orders for any pain meds.
I got some in my purse.
Nurse Hart! If you want to begin and continue employment with this hospital, you will keep the contents of your purse in your purse. Do you understand me, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Get your things together and report to the nurse's station.
Yes. I hope to see you later.
Well, I ain't going nowhere.
I wish I could say the same thing.
Nurse Harley!
Whoa.
Now, that's what I like to see. Someone who falls right down in the chair. Cuts my workload in half. Think you can teach that big guy in 304?
I'm not the patient.
Well, you keep falling down like that, you will be. I mean, what do you think? This is a hospital.
I'm sorry. I'm just supposed to report to Nurse Lisa right away.
Oh, a new recruit. You tell old Drill Sergeant Lisa that soon-to-be Dr. Matt said you could walk as slow as you want all the way to the nurse's station.
Yes, sir.
Don't call me sir. You're a nurse. I'm an orderly. You're way higher on the ladder than I am, which is kind of scary for the rest of you.
You're right. It's just, I am so nervous.
Don't be nervous. Smile. Remember, Jesus loves you, and Nurse Lisa can't eat you.
I sure am glad.
Nice kid. Clumsy, but nice.
Yeah, I guess.
Well, you ready to depart? Your chariot awaits.
Matt, do you know why I'm having to go back to the lab for more tests? I mean, I had an echocardiogram yesterday.
Now, Teresa, that is classified information. Top secret. Only on a need-to-know basis.
You don't know, do you?
I don't have a clue.
That's what I figured.
I tell you what it is. It's probably a case where one doctor is talking to another doctor. Neither one of them know what to do. And in the medical field, you just run more tests.
Well, for somebody who wants to be a doctor, you sure don't have good things to say about doctors.
Oh, I love doctors, as soon as they realize they're not God.
Well, what do you mean by that?
Well, it's like my professor once said, doctors treat people, but God heals them. Jesus is the great physician.
And in your mind, you actually believe that.
Latrice, you can't believe that in your mind. You have to believe it in something bigger, like your heart.
Well, I guess that's the problem. I've got a problem with my heart.
Take a look at that little thumper, shall
All
we?
All right, let's go.
Today's tour features the cardiac lab, where you'll find features as blood pressure cuffs, treadmills, and the ever-popular EKG monitor. Please remain seated until we come to a complete stop, and I've turned off all fastened seatbelt signs.
Who can pick a beggar up off of the street, give him clean clothes and food to eat? God can. I know God can. Who can take a heart that's bitter and cold, make it brand new till it shines like gold? God can. I know God can. God can take away all your pain, make the sunshine chase the rain. Yesterday, today, and forever the same. All you gotta do is just call his name. Who can put a family back together again? Who let their guard down and the devil crept in? God can. I know God can. Who can reach down to the trembling hand of a child that's abused and don't understand? God can. I know God can. God can take away all your pain, make the sunshine chase the rain. Yesterday, today, and forever the same. All you gotta do is just call his name. God can take away all your pain, make the sunshine chase the rain. Yesterday, today, and forever the same. All you gotta do is just call his name.
Sweet room. Excuse me, ma'am. This is a private room. I keep telling the missions not to double book these rooms. Do they listen to me? No.
And how are you today? What is it again? Soon to be Dr. Matt.
That's right, and I'm fine. And how are you, oh concerned Katie?
I'm fine. I guess the real question is, how is she?
Her? She's terrible. I gave her the greatest tour to and from the cardiac lab, not to mention the greatest comedy on the whole third floor. She ain't even offered me a tip.
Here's a tip. Don't quit medical school.
See what I have to deal with?
Do you not have somebody else you could go bother?
Matter of fact, I do. I think I'll go down to the supply closet and replace all the tongue depressors with Jell-O. Old Nurse Lisa will love that one.
Now, there goes someone who really loves their job.
Yeah. Well, speaking of jobs, how's mine?
Oh, everything's fine. Everyone at the office is thinking about you and wishing you the best. And Mr. Davis, he said not to worry about anything. Take all the time you need and just get well.
He sure is a nice man. You know, I've been here in the hospital more than I've been on the job ever since he hired me.
That's not your fault, Latresa. Hey, I did talk to your nephew this morning. He said that Wade's doing fine, that he just misses his mom. And he said they're going to try to come Saturday to visit you. Oh, and he said that Wade did wonderful in his Christmas program last night at church.
I wish I could have seen his Christmas program.
He's going to be fine.
Oh, I hope they come Saturday. I can't wait to see him. No, I don't want him to come. I mean, that little feller's just been through enough, you know? I mean, his dad goes off and leaves him. His mama's too sick to take care of him. I'm glad he's got Jacob to take care of him and watch over him, take him to church. Boy, I've made some mistakes.
He's going to be fine. Don't worry.
Katie, I'm afraid I've messed my life up, but I've not just messed mine up. I've messed his up, too.
Well, you know, God has a way of doing great things with a mess.
Now, Katie, I love you to death, but now how many times do I have to tell you I don't want to hear about this God stuff? You and God, that's good. Me and God, I don't want no part of it.
Okay.
Hello. How are you feeling, Mrs. Teresa?
Well, I'm kind of tired.
Well, that's to be expected. Nurse Lisa, let's make sure we get her on an iron supplement. Let's also up the protein in her diet, too.
Yes, sir.
Doc, you're looking at me like you've got something that you need to say, but you probably don't want to say it.
Well, Latresa, we've been looking at your latest test results. It appears that your heart is just not responding to any of our methods.
What does that mean?
Well, it means that from now on, we really need to focus on our last option.
A transplant.
Yes.
Well, I just don't see that happening.
Why? You've been an assistant for quite a while. You have a great matching profile. All we have to do now is just wait and hope that a donor becomes available soon.
You mean we got to wait till somebody dies?
Well, Latresa, sometimes death is necessary for life.
Well, Doc, I just can't see it happening, you know? I mean, nothing good has ever happened in my life, and nobody ain't never done nothing good for me. I just don't see it happening now.
Well, Latresa, we're going to go for now and let you get some rest, but we'll talk about this later, okay?
Yeah.
I'll send someone down with your night meds in just a little while. And ma'am, visiting hours are almost over.
I won't stay long. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. I mean, I've always known I just had a heart that wasn't good. You know, my heart's not good enough.
Well, in a way, we all do.
Now, what do you mean by that?
Well, it's something the doctor said a minute ago. He said, sometimes death is necessary for life. It just made me think of Jesus, how Jesus had to die so that we can live.
Katie, we've already talked about it. I mean, I know you love the Lord, and I know that you love your church. But I've been to church, And I know it wasn't the same for me. I just know what them people was thinking about me. There, look at her. She's the one who messed up. That girl, her husband left her. She can't even stay home and take care of her youngin', sick all the time. I don't want no part of it.
Latresa, I'm sure no one is thinking those things except for you. And that's beside the point anyway. I'm not talking about church. I'm talking about Jesus. And it's just like you said, we were all born with hearts that just aren't good enough. Not physical hearts, but spiritual ones. And Jesus had to die so that we can have his heart.
Well, excuse me if I'm just a little bit concerned about my physical condition.
Oh, I'm sorry. I know. I understand. I didn't mean to upset you. I'll just leave, and I'll come back tomorrow. Latresa, I just want you to know that God does love you, and he wants to give you an even greater heart transplant, one that can't be measured on that monitor.
Jesus swapped a spotless castle for a grimy stable. He exchanged the worship of angels for the company of killers. He could hold the universe in his palm, but gave it up to float in the womb of a maiden. He humbled himself. He went from commanding angels to sleeping in the straw, from holding stars to clutching Mary's finger. Love goes the distance. Christ traveled from a limitless eternity to be confined by time in order to become one of us. He did it because of love. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth upon him should not perish but have everlasting life.
glad he sees what we don't. And I am so glad he sees what we don't.
Good morning, Latresa. I'm sorry to wake you, but it's time for your breakfast.
Oh, that's okay. I'm glad to see you're still here.
Me too, especially after what happened yesterday.
What happened yesterday?
Well, you know, we had to go through that hospital orientation for 4 hours. You had to sit and listen to all the things that you could be fired for. When it was over, I was a nervous wreck. My first assignment was to take a blood sample from Mr. Waters in room 319. Just a prick in his finger, a couple drops on the slide is all they needed. No big deal, right?
Oh, let me guess, it was a big deal.
Oh, yeah. Started off fine. I pricked his finger. He told me it didn't even hurt him. Then, as I was turning around, I tripped on that stupid handle on the foot of his bed. And I still had the blade in my hand. I tripped into his IV pole, and you'd be surprised at how much liquid can come from one little hole.
Was it bad?
Bad! It was terrible! There was liquid antibiotics spraying all over the room, on the wall, in the bed, in Mr. Waters' hair. Well, I felt really bad, so I began to clean it up. But I still had that blade in my hand.
Oh, no. Don't tell me you cut Mr. Waters.
7 stitches.
Oh, Nurse Lisa?
Not happy.
What's she gonna do?
Already did it. Probation. If I make one more mistake in the next 6 months, I'll have the shortest career of anybody who graduated in the top 10% of nursing school.
Oh, man.
Ha. Well, if it ain't the slasher of room 319.
Good morning, Matt. Good morning, Mr. Team. Matt, I would appreciate it if you didn't make fun of me in front of our patients.
Oh, honey, don't worry about him. He only picks on the ones he likes. You can't do anything about what happened yesterday.
You know about it?
The whole hospital knows about it. As a matter of fact, there's a camera crew downstairs from 60 Minutes and Good Morning America.
That is not funny.
Little lady, you've heard it said, everybody has their 15 minutes of fame. The way I figure it, we've all had that much or more. Maybe yesterday was one of those days for you. Look, you're a nurse. You were here, put here to help people. And you can't do one thing about what happened yesterday. But you sure can make today a whole lot better for a whole lot of people.
You think so?
I know so.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. Thanks again.
Nice kid. Clumsy, but nice.
Yeah. What are you two doing here?
Well, I was taking Mike on a stroll in the patio. I was wondering if you wanted to join us.
Mark, you don't have to...
Matt.
Whatever your name is. Yeah. You don't have to try to cheer me up.
Now, why would I, Matt, a soon-to-be doctor, want to do something like that?
Because you know about my test results. And you feel sorry for me, and you don't have to. I feel sorry enough for myself.
Mighty fine book you got there. I got one just like it.
That's not mine. It belongs to the hospital.
Oh, no. Now, I'd say that's a book that belongs to everybody.
Why do you say that?
I know the author.
The author? You mean God?
Yeah.
We're going
to
be here a while, aren't we?
I'd like to get just a little bit more specific.
I said we're going to be here a while, aren't we?
What are you in such a hurry about?
Evidently
what
have
you got
nothing.
To do that's so blame important?
Evidently nothing.
Good. Now, where was I?
You were saying something about being specific.
Oh, yeah. The danger comes when people try to make God be whoever they want him to be. But with Jesus, it's personal because he's a real person.
Yeah, and he died for you. You love him because he died for you.
Yeah, but that's not all. You see, there have been a lot of people died because they loved somebody. But Jesus is the only one that had the power to live again.
Yeah, Easter.
Well, the world calls it Easter. I call it my way home.
Well, why do you call it that?
Because Jesus died and rose again and lives forever. And I accepted him as my personal Savior. And now, when this old body dies, I go to live with him forever.
How can you know him personally?
Well, it's a whole lot easier than most folks make it out to be.
Boy, ain't that the truth.
Who's telling this story, me or you? Like I was saying, I met the Lord a long time ago. I was a 19-year-old boy overseas, scared to death.
Scared of dying.
Yeah, scared of dying, but more scared of living. Living and not knowing what I was living for. So that night, I asked Jesus into my life, and he changed my heart.
I'm just not sure.
Well, I think it's time to make sure. Let me show you what Jesus says. I got some scripture bookmarked here in my Bible that I like to share with new folks. Now, the first step in salvation is to know that we're all sinners, every one of us. Romans 3 and 10 says, as it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. And then Romans 3 and 23 says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Next, you need to know that there is a price that must be paid because of sin. Romans 6 and 23 says, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Now, this price can be paid by you with eternity in hell, or you can accept the price that Jesus paid on the cross for our sins. Romans 5 and 8 says, but God commendeth his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. To accept Jesus' payment for sin, simply call on his name and ask him to forgive you, and he will save you. Romans 10 and 9 says this, that if thou shalt confess with the mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. For the scripture said, whosoever believeth on him shall not be ashamed, for there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek. For the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. Look here. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Now, if you're ready to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, take time to pray, confessing your sin and asking him to change your heart and to save you. When you accept Jesus, he is faithful to do what he says he'll do. He forgives you and he saves you. 1 John 5 and 13 says this. Look here. For these things I have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that you may know that you have eternal life, and that you may believe on the name of the Son of God. Well, what are you waiting on, boy? Get me the patio. I ain't got all day, you know.
Amen. You sure you don't want to go with us?
No, I'm sure. I've not even had my breakfast yet. I wouldn't be good company.
That is hospital food. You don't want to eat that. That stuff will kill you.
Why me, Lord? What have I ever done to deserve even one of the pleasures I've known? Tell me, Lord, what did I ever do that was worth loving you or the kindness you've shown?
Your dinner. You haven't eaten much all day.
Have you tasted that stuff?
No. Nurse Lisa would kill me.
Not as fast as that food would.
Well, I guess I'll take your tray if you're not gonna eat any. Katie, maybe you can talk her into eating something.
Oh, I think I can persuade her.
That's not on her diet, okay? Listen, I do not know about this. Do you guys understand? I do not know about this!
You keep that up, she'll be the one with heart failure.
How are you feeling?
Actually, I'm feeling a little bit better.
I'm good. Hey, Latresa, I'm sorry for upsetting you yesterday. I just worry about you.
You know, Katie, I've been thinking. And I believe you're right. I mean, I really believe that I've been blaming God for all my problems and everything that's ever happened in my life. And I believe He's really the only one who can actually help me and the only one who actually cares about me. I believe I'd like to be saved.
You're kidding. Here? Right now?
Yeah, but I don't know what to do.
Just ask Him. He's been waiting just to hear your voice.
Can we pray?
Yes.
Lord, this isn't easy, and I don't know what to say, but I believe that your word is true, and I believe that you died for me, and I believe that you live so that I can live, and I want to know you, Lord. I pray you'd forgive me for all the bad stuff I've done, and I just pray you'd help me, Lord. I don't know what to say. I just know I want you to be the Lord of my life. I want to give my life to you, Lord. I'm scared. And I don't want to be mad anymore, Lord. I want to live for you. Please save me, Lord. Please. Amen.
Amen.
Try to come here.
Room sits God Almighty as a judge upon His throne. Holiness is all around Him as He judges sin and wrong. Satan is the old accuser as
as he stands before the king with his list of accusations. All my sins he tries to breathe as he points accusing fingers to where I stand. Child, I'm here, you're not alone.
That's my Savior, my interceder, and he's standing in my place as he stands before the Father. He speaks one word.
Accepting Jesus as your personal Savior is the best thing you could ever do. I'm so proud of you, and I know Wade will be too. How do you feel?
Different, warm, to be honest, hungry.
Hungry is good. Let's celebrate.
You haven't started eating the pizza yet, have you? Oh, no.
What are you doing?
Okay. Nurse Lisa and Dr. Jones are on their way to see you in any second. And if they found out, I'll let you have pizza. I'm history.
Pizza. Hey, Doc.
Hi, Doc.
Nurse Harley.
I'm sorry. Hello, Dr. Jones.
Wow. What's going on? You sure seem in a lot better spirits than last time I saw you.
I truly am, Doc.
Well, I'm glad to hear that. I have some very big news, Latricia. We've learned that a heart has just become available, and we think it's a perfect match.
Oh, thank God.
But, Latricia, our window of opportunity for a successful transplant is very short. So if you're ready, we have to get started right now.
Two heart transplants in one day. This has to be a record.
Excuse me?
Dr. Jones, I just got saved. I just accepted the Lord as my Savior.
Well, that is wonderful, Latricia. Ultimately, Jesus is the great physician. And he also said in his word that he'd never leave thee nor forsake thee. But please understand, this is a very sensitive procedure. And I'm obligated to tell you that many things could go wrong. The risks are considered high.
Well, you know what? For the first time in my life, I'm okay with that. I mean, I trust the Lord with my life. And no matter how much time I have left, I know that He's got a plan for me. And I'm okay with it.
Well, then let's do this. Nurse Lisa, will you please go down and alert the prep team?
Right away, Doctor.
I'll see you when you wake up. And oh, Harley, we won't tell anyone about the pizza.
In the I'm praying for assurance everything's gonna be alright. Lord, I see another battle out in front of me. I'm afraid I won't be able, and I'll go down in defeat. And he said, do you remember where I brought you from? Just take a look behind you at how far you've come. And every time you ask me, didn't I deliver you? So why would you be thinking that I wouldn't see you through? And didn't I walk on the water and I calmed a raging sea? I spoke to the wind, it hushed and I gave you peace. Didn't I run to your rescue? Didn't I hear you when you called? I walked right beside you just so you wouldn't fall. Didn't I leave all of heaven just to die for your sin? I searched until I found you, and I'd do it all again. And now she's talking to her father in a house that was once a home. Said, my bills are coming due, Lord. 6 days is not that long. She hears a voice so soft and low. Says, I moved like that before. I'll do this little thing, oh, and I'll give you so much more. Didn't I walk on the water and I calmed their agency? I spoke to the wind, it hushed and I gave you peace. Didn't I run to your rescue? Didn't I hear you when you called? I walked right beside you just so you wouldn't fall. Didn't I leave all of heaven just to die for your sin? I searched until I found you, and I do it all again. Didn't I leave all of heaven just to die for your sin? I searched until I found you, and I do.
Are these all of your things?
I think so.
Latresa, so far everything looks good. We see no signs of rejection. But you'll have to keep a close eye on you, and I know you can't wait to see your son. But please take it easy. Don't try to do too much until you get your strength back.
Yes, ma'am, and thank you.
You're welcome.
Someone call for a taxi?
That would be me.
Well, we want to thank you for being a guest today at Hearts Are Us. And for playing, we've got some lovely parting gifts, such as your very own plastic water pitcher and a lifetime supply of anti-rejection drugs.
You need help.
So true. You going to carry that?
Yes.
$50 says you don't make it.
For your information, I haven't dropped anything all day.
We have a winner.
Hey, Matt.
Yeah?
Maybe you should just let me push Latresa out. Nurse Lisa said she wanted to see you right away. Something about Jell-O.
This will not be pleasant.
No.
Smile, Matt. Jesus loves you. And Nurse Lisa can't eat you.
I don't know about that last one.
Okay.
Well, I've never tasted champagne. I've never fed with a popular crowd. I've been told by some around me this world's fun and I've missed out.
I enjoyed that tonight. I really did. Now, as you can see, it was funny. We've got some pretty funny people here at Sweetgum. We thank the Lord for that. At the same time, there's a very serious side to this play about the condition of our heart. You know, we can have heart trouble physically, but we've all born with heart trouble spiritually. We're all lost sinners until we get saved. And it could be tonight that there's somebody here and God's revealed unto you here tonight the condition of your heart spiritually and that you realize tonight that you need Jesus. So we want to have a moment of invitation. I believe Dickie maybe is going to sing a song here. And we want to invite you tonight
This is your opportunity. Maybe it's been a while since you've been to church. Maybe you ain't never been to church. But you've come tonight and the Spirit of God has dealt with you. Latricia, she got saved there in the hospital in that play. You get saved when God's Spirit deals with you and reveals to you that you're lost and you call upon the name of Jesus. It's so easy to get saved when God's dealing with you. You just call upon His name. His promise is He'll save you. His condition is you call upon His name. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. That's good news tonight. We love you, and I want you to right now just be sensitive to the Holy Spirit. They're going to sing one more song. And if you need to come, we'll meet you in the altar and pray with you.
A surgery in my heart. It took the great physician's hand to ease the pain that sin had brought and take away this awful shame. My life is changed, I will endure. In Jesus' arms I feel secure. Now I have a brand new start. He did a surgery in my heart. Now there's healing in the blood that He shed so willingly. There's no way I can explain what my Savior means to me. He took away the hurt and pain. I've got heaven now to gain. He did a surgery in my heart. When He fixed the broken part, come down to the end, life's tolls and heartaches will end. My family gathered all around, they'll pray that grace will sure abound. Heaven's beauty I will see. My mom and dad will welcome me. Because the victory has been won by the blood of God's own Son. Now there's healing in the blood that He shed so willingly. There's no way I can explain what my Savior means to me. Took away the hurt and pain. I've got heaven now to gain. He did a surgery in my heart. When He fixed the broken part, He did a surgery in my heart. When He fixed the broken part.
do you